In this video, we give our brutally honest ratings of our recent trip to Spiti Valley. This whole trip was planned and organized by The Travel Story. Here's how it went down.
We are finally back to Delhi.
We just got out. It felt like someone threw us into an oven.
I felt like I'm the pow in the oven.
Even the driver's laughing.
Gunpo has finally arrived to pick us up. Say hi, Gunpo.
Hello.
Things are finally starting off. Yeah. Look at her.
Ideally, what they should have done is kept a break over here in Shimla for a while.
Sleep is for the weak. Rest is for the weak. Let's go, 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 go.
Guarantee you in 20 minutes, she's going to be passed out next to me.
Guys, know it's not all cold everywhere. No, it isn't. Right now, we are burning more than when we were in Delhi. We are 5 hours away from Chitkul, and the temperature is like at 35 degrees right now. But it feels like
100.
My God, it is excruciatingly hot. So we just saw the weather on Google Maps in Spiti. It's minus 12 in the night, and it's minus 2 during the daytime. These are the kind of temperature fluctuations we're facing right now, and we are going to be facing even more drastic ones. So, God help us.
I'm a burnt chapati.
How are these guys not roasting in this heat? Look at this one's Anand.
I know.
Sitting in the car.
I'm a melted cupcake right now, I feel like.
And those champs, my goodness, hats off, yaar. Hats off or take your helmets off.
I'm tired. I can't laugh.
Gunpo, अभी क्या बोले थे आप?
ये हिमाचल के सबसे गर्म जगहों में से एक है, रामपुर बुशहर ना।
यहाँ पे टेम्परेचर कितना जाता है?
यहाँ पे तो आप 40 तक चला जाता है।
40 तक? Okay, I think I need to pour some water on your head.
Choice of bread reserves. And cereals.
What do you want, baby? The Office, Big Bang Theory, Friends.
I want the plain paratha.
So you want the plain cake? Do you want that along with your peached eggs? Let's go, Gunpo.
The roads are getting worse, but the view is getting better and better.
The place where we're at right now is called Sangla or Sangla. This is our last pit stop before we head to Rupin Riverview at Chitkul. This town is the last place where you can buy all your knickknacks and stuff. So let's see, hopefully the chicken momos over here are good, and then we'll see you at Rupin Riverview. Hot, hot steam momos. Let's go, my hands are burning. Woo, that's good. This is nice, this is nice. Oh wow! This looks nice. You
feeling cold?
I'm loving it. Chalo.
Bed. Finally. After 24 hours, let's freshen up. Hello people!
I'm so happy we did it.
How are you liking the room?
So cozy, I'm so happy.
It is so lovely.
And
ekdam saaf,
10 out of 10.
Even the loo is absolutely clean, which is a huge bonus for me.
Like, the service is so good, they're so prompt.
Really helpful, really sweet people, very, very warm staff. The biggest bonus for me here is that we are 8 kilometers away from the Indo-Tibetan border. So you don't expect this kind of comfort at this place. So in terms of that, great place to stay in. Very good choice by The Travel Stories. I think it's time for us to give our first rating.
For me, it's 10 out of 10.
Given where we are and given the level of comfort we're getting over here, 10 out of 10. Very, very good start, yeah. I must say. Okay, that's one. It's around 13 degrees right now. Over the span of the night, it's going to reach around 8 degrees by around 4 a.m. I feel if you're coming to a place like this and you're not a very frequent traveler here, do come with someone who can guide you, preferably a local. Like, we got very lucky that we have Travel Story who have hooked us up with this guy. What's his name?
GoPro.
GoPro? No, it's not GoPro.
I keep forgetting his name,
yaar. No, what's his name?
I don't know, yaar.
GonPro.
Haan, yeah. GoPro main bol rahi hu.
So we have GonPro with us and he knows everything in and out and he's ready to help with anything and whatever you want. At no given point are we feeling lost. In fact, we are feeling very familiar with this place,
yeah.
Because he's making us feel so comfortable. By the way, yeah, network. Vodafone and Airtel doesn't exist over here. Jio is the only thing that works. 5G all the time. And now it's time for us to go have some Rajma Chao.
Yeah.
Because of your bloody GoPro, I've been calling him GonPro. His name is GonPo. Sorry, GonPo. Bloody nonsense. It's 6 in the morning and I absolutely cannot believe where I am. Why the change from Bombay?
What is this?
This is incredible.
God, I have tears in my eyes. I can't feel anything.
Same. Just cannot believe where we are right now.
My God. I can't believe you're sleeping here.
My God, this is incredible. This could probably be the best feeling in the world.
I too have told you very clearly what my ratings are. What are you? Oh my God, you're looking very handsome. Minus the hair for me. Just sit like that. I'm taking a picture. Sorry, I got distracted by your beauty.
Isn't the hair growing on you, by the way?
Yeah, it is. Achha, bata do, what are your ratings?
What are my ratings? I already gave a 10 on 10 last night without the view. Now what? Should we increase the scale to on 100? I mean, yeah, I can say 12 on 10, 15 on 10. I wish I could give it 100 on 10, but it's a 10 on 10.
Yeah. How are the parathas?
Come, you also eat. We need to fuel up before we go. We have a long day ahead.
Come. Enjoy the parathas with this view.
Hey, what else do you want, man? My goodness. Come on. Don't get stuck here. It's going to get better. Trust me. Let's go.
Show me your priorities.
These are my priorities.
And this is only bag number one. How many bags like this do you have?
Two more. Using sunscreen in the mountains is even more important than any other place because the atmosphere here is very, very thin, so there's less protection from the UV rays of the sun. Carry as much sunscreen as you can if you're ever coming to the mountains.
I have no idea that you could be here. Nice to meet you, sir. Seriously. I used to watch your videos. I enjoy them.
You used to or you still watch?
I still watch. Yeah.
Let's go, GonPo. Acha, GonPo, abhi se main aapko bulaunga GonBro.
GonBro.
Yes, theek hai? To main ro bro, aap GonBro aur ye GonGirl. Okay, so thank you, Rupen Riverview. You guys were amazing. But now,
Our Spiti Circuit
officially begins.
Woo!
Let's go! Okay, and now it's time to whip out the Insta360 X4
wow.
To capture some of the most mind-blowing shots. Let's go! India's last village, Chetkul. Wow, it's incredible. That is the temple that we're heading to now. Let's see how it is. So we're at this temple in Chetkul. To tell us more about it is GonBro.
जो ये मंदिर है मेन देवता है उनका मंदिर है.
देवता कौन सा है?
अलग अलग देवता है हर गांव में ना. ओके. इनके गांव का देवता है तो जैसे बाहर निकालते हैं तो इनको यहाँ पे
रखते हैं.
हाँ जी.
ओके.
तो जब बाहर आते हैं तो कोई भी लड़कियाँ जो है वो इनके सामने नहीं आ सकते.
लड़कियाँ नहीं आ सकते क्यों?
मतलब इनका है रीति रिवाज ना, जो यहाँ पे ट्रेडिशनल किनोरी टोपी है वो भी कम्पल्सरी पहनना पड़ेगा.
तो अभी हम ऐसे आ गए अंदर, ऐसे अलाउड है?
अभी अलाउड है, जब देवता निकालेंगे तभी.
वो जब निकालेंगे तभी. ओके. तो वेरी religious people.
बहुत religious है.
matching. So here we are
finally at first quadrant. Just kidding.
The river's up ahead. This is Baspa River. Time to give our ratings. What do you think?
I can't. It's not fair.
Yeah.
Every place I think is going to be a 10 on 10. I would give more than 10.
So the 10 on 10 for you?
Yeah.
So I would give this place an 8 on 10. For me, I know for a fact, see, the town itself is okay. The river as well, it was very crowded, there were a lot of people. So we had to walk further down a little bit to get an isolated spot. The only reason I think you should be visiting Chitkul is to be able to go back home and tell people that you were at the last village in India. So for me, it was an 8 on 10. For Kanu, it was a 10 on 10. And I have a feeling every place for her will be a 10 on 10. Alright, so now we're headed to Kalpa. So we'll see you guys there. Can you just hold that against your face once? That has got to be the largest chip this uncle has ever chipped. My goodness. Look at the size of that. Do you want to take a bite and ruin it?
No, I don't
And of course, this is needless to say, but carry something around with you in which you can throw all the trash.
If you see garbage, pick it up once.
Yeah, pick it up. So just one small little thing to keep in mind to preserve such beautiful places. Okay, so we made a small pit stop at Sangla village to eat some lunch and it has officially started drizzling. I really hope this doesn't get any worse. My God. My goodness. So much dust. Even the temperature has dropped drastically in seconds. Chilled weather, hot steamed chicken momos
with spicy chutney.
What a life, what a life.
Wow.
It started clearing up, so good signs. Madam's Rajma Chawal. Round 3?
I don't know, yeah. Kitne round hote hain.
Let's go, gone po.
Chalo, sir.
Okay, gone bro. Sabse best log country mein kahan se aate hain?
Mumbai ho gaye.
Bombay, no? Well done, Bombay.
Where are my churas? I want to be here with newly married couples. They talk like, Rohit ji, mujhe bahut thandi lag rahi hai. Hum room pe jaye kya?
Kya room pe? Are the children watching for you?
Mujhe room pe bed mein jaake TV dekhna is possible.
So we just stopped at this place called Rikong Pio, but we cannot find a coffee shop anywhere. Not coffee shop, just a place that serves coffee. The cafeteria roof. It's quite a walk. I knew it. See, it's right there. Small walk it is. So a very sweet pedestrian has told us, shopping complex mein milega coffee. But it's again, it's on top. There's another midtown cafe, but again, it's upstairs. See, there's another one, there's a little chef. There's only one flight or staircase you have to walk up.
I'm doing that.
Come. Why are we looking at the menu? You wanted coffee, right?
I've seen it there, Hamas.
I'm fine. You have your coffee, that's it. You nonsense. Done with the coffee?
Chai.
Asking for coffee everywhere and she ended up having chai.
So careful.
White Nest. Finally at our stay at Kalpa. How'd you like it?
Very, very nice.
Now this looks good from the outside. Let's see the inside. How's it? Oh, so cozy. Not bad at all. Perfect, very good here. Lovely place. Heading to the terrace. Let's see. Oh my. Oh.
What more could you possibly ask for? Okay, so apparently there are 5 Kailashes in total. The one we are looking at over here is Kinnar Kailash, one of the 5. And right between the mountains is a valley. In that valley, there is a shivling, a 70-foot shivling. Let's hope the clouds clear tomorrow morning because the sun rises right behind those mountains. Come have a look at this.
God, it's like I'm hugging the mountain.
How insane is this?
See the picture, he'll show you. This is Neeche here.
ये किधर है?
ये यहीं से थोड़ा आगे जाके थोड़ा सा.
Snowfall होता है तो ऐसा होता है? ये कब था भाई?
ये सर February.
Oh my God, यहाँ पे अभी इस time पे snowfall होता है?
इस time पे तो सर हो सकता है, लग के ऊपर है.
Shit यार. आपको क्या लगता है ये क्लाउड कवर जो है यहाँ पे ये हटेगा कल सुबह सनराइज के टाइम पे? ओके, आई एम गेटिंग माय होप्स अप हाई, बट दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली एपिक. मजा आ गया ब्रो, मजा आ गया. द ग्रैंड शंबाला, आई गेस दे हैव देयर वाईफाई पासवर्ड रिटन ऑन देयर होटल. You don't know the reference?
No.
Okay, so if any of you got the reference, write it down in the comments. Where is Shambhala, the Wi-Fi password? These Nasher Miles suitcases have been a blessing or not?
Yes.
My goodness.
They've gone through hell.
And they've helped out so much because there's so much climbing and carrying to do. This is making our luggage so lightweight. So this was a very good decision. Yeah, all the bellboys are like, "Arey, aapka luggage to itna light hai," which is crazy because we've packed a lot. So thanks, yeah, guys at Nasher for hooking us up.
6 in the morning and we have someone doing exercises to stay warm. But no, we're actually here to try to catch the sunrise. Apparently, that on top of the mountain over there is what the shivling is. That is supposed to be around 79 feet tall.
Thank you, Hotel White Nest, for a lovely stay and a breathtaking view. But now we're off to our next stop. Let's go, Gonpo! All set, madam?
Yes!
So, time to rate this place. What rating would you give it?
8. Actually, 8.
Why did you lose?
White lights. That is 2 points.
That is the whole 2 points?
Yeah. I'm okay with the stay. The water was hot. The views are great.
She really likes those warm lights in the room. It feels cozy. Well, for me, it was a 9 on 10. I mean, I know as we progress, the stays are going to get not so great.
Not so great.
Of course, because the facilities are not available so high up. The service, I felt, was slightly slow. But the room was amazing. Bathroom was absolutely clean, which is a huge bonus for me. And the view. I mean, what more do you want, right?
So 10. For me, final, sir.
And for me, a 9 on 10. So gone, bro. The first stop is Khab Sangam.
Mm-hmm.
Excellent. So Khab Sangam is basically the confluence of the Spiti River and the Sutlej River. So that'll be very interesting to see. Gone, bro.
Yes, sir.
Khab Bridge hai wahan pe. Okay. So from the bridge, we're going to be looking at the two rivers. I can't
make a call
for the phone. So I just asked Gonpo if he drinks and he says he doesn't. So I asked him if he doesn't drink by choice or his wife doesn't allow him. So aapne kya bola?
Party mein to theek tha pi lete hain, matlab.
Aur aapko kya karna padta hai?
To utha ke lana padta hai. Aap dono ne 10-10 minute baad pani peete rehna.
Kyun?
Kyunki hum abhi yahan se height gain karenge na. Abhi tak to hum down pe the na.
Baap re.
12,000 pe jayenge.
Very good. So he's telling us to drink water every 10 minutes and that's actually something very very important because the cold weather makes you feel like you're not thirsty for some reason. So without knowing it, we've actually been drinking very little water as compared to how much we drink back home in Bombay. Have you been drinking plenty of water?
No, I don't drink water either there or here.
Okay, some people are as useless as this one. Yeah, so this is the Khab Bridge. This is where the two rivers meet, the Sutlej and the Spiti River. The river that's coming down from straight below the bridge is the Sutlej, and the one that comes from the mountains is Spiti. Pretty cool. I don't know if you can tell the distinction. The colors are pretty much the same, but you can tell exactly where they meet. It's pretty awesome. Okay, so that was the Khab Sangam Bridge. What do you think? How was it?
It was good. I like the flags on the bridge, but the color of the rivers are pretty much the same. For me, I felt like two different streams of the same river.
I mean, that is what is the interesting thing about this, is the two rivers meeting. It is exactly what you hear. It's a very quick stop for you guys who want to take a few pictures and leave. The flags on the bridge look really good. I rate the place around...
-7.5.
You're the 7.5?
Yeah.
I would rate the place around 6. 6 on 10, 7.5 on 10. See you on the next stop. And here we've arrived at Naco. Finally.
Let's eat something
new. I believe your options are momos, thukpa and chow mein. So Gonpur was right. All the places from here on, you can expect rajma chawal or momos. That's about it. So the rajma chawal was actually preferred over here. The momos were like onion momos, not chicken momos. Barely any chicken in them. But yeah, that was our quick stop at Naco. And now on to the next stop. The temperature over here says 12 degrees feels like 11. But I'd say it's more like 12 degrees feels like 40. Sizzling hot.
Either I'm burning or I'm freezing.
So over here, the bro, the border road organization, they have these warning signs put everywhere, like one-liner dad jokes. So there was one, darling, I like you, but not so fast.
Another one is, drive on horsepower, not on rum power.
If you love her, please divorce speed. This is my favorite. It's better to be known as Mr. Late than the late Mr.
स्पीति एरिया वाइज में ना हिमाचल का सबसे बड़ा
और
पॉपुलेशन वाइज सबसे कम है हिमाचल का.
दैट इज प्रीटी कूल. लार्जेस्ट प्लेस विद द लीस्ट अमाउंट ऑफ पीपल. वेलकम टू स्पीति वैली. ओके, सो दिस इज द स्पीति वैली का एंट्रेंस.
अभी यहां से स्टार्ट हो जाएंगे, रोड भी सिंगल हो जाएंगे.
एट सम प्लेसेस ओवर हियर द हीट कैन गेट एक्सट्रीमली सिवियर. द सनलाइट हिट्स सो डायरेक्टली इट कैन बर्न योर स्किन एंड योर स्किन स्टार्ट्स पीलिंग ऑफ. सो रिमेंबर दैट इवन इफ इट्स हॉट, कीप योर स्लीव्स रोल्ड डाउन और वेयर अ जैकेट.
आपको घर पे रहना ज्यादा पसंद है, आपको ऐसा ट्रैवल करना ज्यादा अच्छा लगता है?
महीने में 3 या 4 दिन ठीक है
घर में, है ना? क्यों?
इससे ज्यादा बैठ गए ना तो रोटियां बनवाएंगे, पता नहीं क्या क्या करवाएंगे.
First, taking the whole Spiti circuit rather than being at home. Oh God, ये तो बहुत funny है यार.
तो आपने मेरे को थोड़े time पहले बोला था कि आप ये काम 18 साल से कर रहे हो और महीने में 4 बार Spiti का पूरा circuit करते हो. तो मतलब जिंदगी में 720 times आप ये Spiti circuit कर चुके हो.
हाँ जी.
बीवी की वजह से?
आपकी शादी को कितने साल हुए?
6-7 साल.
उससे पहले
तो मैं सर की बेकम मारता था ना. शादी हुए जब से दादा मारने लग गए.
वो देखती है यूट्यूब?
हाँ जी, यूट्यूब देखती है.
बस तू तो गया. So basically, there was a Buddhist monk, Sangha Tanzin, almost 1,000 years ago. He was meditating right at the spot. Unfortunately, there was an avalanche, and that avalanche buried him alive in the same meditation posture. In 1975, an earthquake revealed everything that the avalanche had buried, and he was found still sitting in the same posture along with a couple of stupas around him. He hasn't been preserved chemically in any which way or form, and there's still a head growing on the mummy. We could even see his teeth, even his ears. Wow, now that's incredible. This, the new monastery that you see, has been built later, but the older one, the smaller one, is the original Gyu monastery. Very, very fascinating. Okay, so that was Gyu monastery. What are your ratings, Kanu?
6.
Six?
Yeah, I've seen better monasteries, even inside the idol of Buddha and all. Yeah.
Okay, not as magnificent as the bigger monasteries, but given the history attached to this?
Yeah, I think 6 only for that.
That's a 6 on 10 from her. I love the history attached to this. I would give it an 8 on 10. It is definitely something that you should come at least see. Cool. Off to our next stop. Okay, gone bro. Next stop?
Next stop for Tabo.
Excellent, excellent. How long?
1.5 hours.
1.5 hours and you get much needed rest.
Oh.
So randomly stones are falling. You have to be so sharp absolutely to notice stones falling. My goodness.
My God, there's so much.
Whoa. My God, that's why. Look at that. So much heavy wind on top. Whoa. Gone bro. बारिश में लैंडस्लाइड्स कितने होते हैं?
जिस दिन बारिश हो रहा है ना,
हाँ,
उस दिन ये है कि लैंडस्लाइड होगा ही होगा.
और कहाँ होगा?
सारे इलाके में होंगे, जैसे किन्नौर हो गए, जैसे काला शहर तो नहीं है, जैसे यहाँ यूं होने से आए ये शहर तो होंगे ही होंगे।
तो मतलब मेजोरिटी जगह में?
हाँ जी, बारिश के दिन तो आप अंदर बैठो घूमने का बिल्कुल मत सोचो, नेक्स्ट डे निकल सकते हैं क्योंकि ये सारे सूख जाते हैं ना, तो बारिश बहुत कम होते हैं ना।
आई थिंक माई पर्सनल ओपिनियन वुड बी डोंट कम ड्यूरिंग द रेन्स,
या अवॉइड कमिंग टू द माउंटेन इन जनरल, जस्ट लाइक लास्ट ईयर व्हाट हैपेंड इन हिमाचल।
अकॉर्डिंग टू व्हाट ही इज सेइंग, लैंडस्लाइड्स आर गिवन 100% व्हेन इट रेन्स, बट देन व्हाई टेक अ चांस एंड गो आउट द नेक्स्ट डे एज वेल, यू नेवर नो।
Green Tara Homestay is going to be our place for tonight at Tavo. Let's have a look.
Oh. Nice, big, cozy room. Okay, wait, I have to see this. Loo? Oh, are you serious?
This is huge.
I am so impressed. Okay. Look at the dustbin. Come on, you have to see it. Put your foot next to it.
The size of that dustbin is the pedal of other dustbins.
What are we looking at?
Very good.
Oh, wow. It's a dining setup. It's nice.
रात को कितना ठंडा हो जाता है?
-1 भी नहीं जाएगी।
Not that cold, huh?
Not that cold.
-1 degrees. That's it.
हमारे लिए बहुत ठंडा है। So it was really sweet. We got to know that the owner's daughter, she said that they're coming. They'll feel cold, so make them stay niche. It's more like a cave and it's warm.
Her really? Street,
yeah.
Wow.
Dog
dinner, Bruno.
Dog tag. Hi.
Hi, Bruno.
So cute.
A few moments later.
Oh, these mountain puppies are so cute. Okay.
That turned from cute to oh, very soon. The heat is on.
Bruno is a naughty dog.
See, never judge a book by its cover.
How are you liking this cafe?
Very cute.
Would you ever expect a cafe like this to be
no.
in a small little village? This is so lovely here.
Oh. This is a local Pithi rose. Even their roses look so different. That's for you.
A rose for row? Do I look cute?
It looks good. Great.
We're in this lovely, quaint little village up in the mountains, 12,000 feet above sea level. We're like 40 kilometers away from the border. It is a lovely place. I mean, it depends on the mindset that you've come here with. Me and Kanu honestly have been very happy over here, right?
If you're coming for luxury and all, then please don't come.
No, absolutely. What I'm trying to say is, we were told that with every passing stop, accommodations are going to get more and more modest. This kind of place is like a Airbnb that you would book in the center of Bombay. It is that good. So we're just going to call it a night right here. See you in the morning.
Here is our breakfast. Poha and bread.
This is the type of poha I also like.
But you wanted parathas, right?
Like Monku likes to say, he's fueling up.
Yep, fueling up. We have another long day. Every day is going to be a long day.
Thank you for welcoming us into your home.
You chose us.
Yeah. We had a lovely time. We'll definitely recommend this place. So this will go on YouTube.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Thank you. So as we wait for our car to be unstuck, what would you rate this homestay?
10 on 10. Maybe 9.5, and that 0.5 is...
Because of the white lights. I knew it. Yeah, it was a lovely time. Wonderful family over here hosting us. And especially the biggest reason being, it was better than what we expected.
Yeah.
Definitely recommend it, guys. It's a 10 on 10 from me. 9.5 because of the white light for Kanu.
Okay, let's go, Gonpo. Where's the first stop?
Tabo Monastery is Piti ka sabse oldest monastery, hai na?
Okay, and then?
Uske baad hum Dankar Monastery jayenge.
Okay, all right.
So basically what happens is, in Bombay, we do club hopping. Over here, we're doing monastery hopping.
The old monastery established in 1996 AD, that is where we're headed right now. The more I'm walking around, the more I'm kind of starting to feel like it has a very ancient Aztec kind of architecture. Wow, ancient Aztec, Egyptian, it's all a mix. You can just feel the history in this place. So this is basically the new monastery, but honestly speaking, there is no comparison between what we've just experienced in there. Entering that old monastery felt like time traveling. It's like we literally walked
right into the past. Unfortunately, we couldn't take any of our cameras or equipment inside. I feel it's a little unfortunate that you guys aren't going to be able to see what we just experienced, but oh my god, it's exactly how it was left back in the day, 1,000 years ago. Very little touch-up done as renovation. Like I said, it's like a portal into the past. The newer stuff just doesn't compare.
Don't come here just to like brush like inside the old monastery. Spend like 2-3 minutes or 5 minutes or more and just sit there with yourself. It feels so good.
For anyone coming to the Tabo Monastery, I definitely recommend it. A 10 on 10 from me.
10 on 10 from me.
We came from here or
what? Huh?
We came from here.
Came in from there as in?
Car's right here.
What?
I think I've come too.
I think you left a bit of yourself in there.
Oh god.
Bloody cartoon.
Let's go, Gonpo. So just a few facts about the Tabo Monastery. It was built 1,000 years ago by King Yishu. He was the king of Western Tibet. This Tabo Monastery is the oldest Buddhist monastery in the country. So there are a lot of statues, murals, paintings all across the walls in the old monastery. It basically represents the meeting point of all the various different Buddhist cultures from across the country, like from Bengal, Odisha, Kashmir, Nepal, and Bihar. So yeah, that wraps up Tabo Monastery. And this is Manya Bridge.
Looks pretty much like all the other bridges you get to see around Himachal. So most of these kind of bridges that you get that you can walk on are kind of broken. This is properly fixed that you can walk across.
Do not make noises.
Bro.
The noisiest thing here is the river, bro.
Okay, so that was Manya Bridge. That's about it, I guess. A bridge. So, what would you rate this place?
7 on 10. Like, it's a nice place to stop. Like, walk over it.
Yeah, walk over it. Wooden, wobbly. But it's still just a bridge over a river. I'll give it a 3 on 10. For me, it's skippable.
It's a rustic bridge, you know?
It's a bridge. Oh. 3 on 10 from me, 7 on 10 from Kanu. Off to our next stop.
Old monastery,
which looks like it's a part of the mountain itself.
Every doorway is so low.
Dhankar Monastery.
So views-wise, you couldn't see much. So yeah. For me, it was like a 6.
I actually went all the way to the top to see the view. And it's pretty much the same view you get from your car. So yeah, I mean, I would definitely say that the Tabo Monastery was much, much better. As far as the rating is concerned, I would rate Dhankar Monastery a 5 on 10. Just because of the way it looks. From the outside.
Oh, I forgot to add. I might give it a 7 because this place had a meditation cave, which was exceptional.
Do check out the meditation cave if you're spiritually inclined. So a 7 on 10 now
from her.
And for me, it still stays the same.
Yeah.
A 5 on 10.
That's just the shape of the mountain, huh? Those aren't houses.
Those are not houses?
Apparently not.
And we're finally at Kaza.
You you have cafes here, you have live music.
Yes.
So there's like a little bit modernization and civilization.
Yeah, a little taste of city life way up in the mountains.
Yes.
Cafe Pithi, that's the one.
Finally, some food.
How does the menu look?
Awesome.
Yeah, finally, a lot of other things apart from momos and rajma chawal.
I cannot begin to explain how bloody delicious this food is.
They're so happy here.
Oh my god, this is incredible. Chawal momos, their shapta, which is their local dish here, and tingmo. It's a kind of bread that they have, a very soft bread, very filling. But oh my god, the flavor is incredible. I mean, look at the view we have. And I haven't looked up off my plate even once. That's crazy.
It is raw.
This is awesome.
Wow. These guys know what they're doing, man.
Usually we always leave the place and give ratings of the place.
I'm halfway through my meal. There's more food that's coming. I'm ready to give my rating already. You go first. I think everyone knows what my rating is.
Mine is a 10 on 10.
Yeah, well, same here. 12 on 10.
And the mountains that we saw on the first day, that was Isar Egaru.
10 on 10. Compared to this, you know what food means to me?
Yeah. But the food is exceptional. The quality
absolutely
is so good.
A perfect way to end today's journey in Gaza with this amazing food. Cafe Pithi. Highly, highly recommend it. Please try it.
After a fantastic meal at Pithi Cafe, we finally checked into our stay at Gaza. But nothing could prepare us for the roller coaster of a journey that was still about to begin. In the next video, we explore some of the grandest locations in all of Spiti Valley, including the biggest highlight of our trip.